Paracas National Reserve in Peru, Loreto Bay National Marine Park in Mexico, Lomas Bay in Chile, and Lake Bañoles in Spain all have something in common. They're all wetlands. But they also have something else in common. They are all Ramsar sites. What are Ramsar sites, and why should they be protected? No other type of ecosystem in the world has the ability to retain as much carbon as wetlands. They are also home to countless birds, reptiles, mammals, fish, amphibians, and plant species. However, despite their importance, wetlands are seriously threatened. They are disappearing 3 times faster than forests. In the 1970s, scientists, governments, and specialists proposed the creation of an international treaty to conserve wetlands. That is how, in 1971, the Ramsar Convention was born. 18 countries joined it. By naming a wetland a Ramsar site, these countries' governments promised to take measures to conserve them. These measures can include adopting management plans, establishing better zoning for urban and agricultural areas, and strengthening scientific research. So far, 2,388 wetlands or Ramsar sites are protected by the convention across the world. Together, these spaces covered more than 253 million hectares. Today, the countries with the most Ramsar sites are the United Kingdom, with 173, and Mexico, with 142. Bolivia has the greatest amount of land under protection. The largest Ramsar sites in the world are the Tumba Ngiri Maindombe in the Democratic Republic of Congo and Queen Maud Gulf in Canada. They both contain over 6 million hectares. But despite all of this effort, wetlands remain seriously threatened. Between 1970 and 2015, 35% of continental, marine, and coastal wetlands decreased drastically. The populations of fish, aquatic birds, and turtles that depend on wetlands are also declining dramatically. 1/4 of these species are under threat of extinction, especially in the tropics.